Welcome to you're watching this show. This isn't live. This is the first time we didn't do a Pittsburgh Sportsline live on Tuesday night. Thanks for watching us on Verizon 32. But we're actually at Sip Sports Bar doing our second show. If you hadn't heard, we're going to White Collar Brawler. As you're watching this, we're at the Hollywood Theater. So if you want to hurry up and see Smokin' Jim and I, Jimmy Savetic, Andy Sebastian, everybody involved in White Collar Brawler, come out to Hollywood Theater. Well, since this is our first tape show, I want to thank everybody at BPTV for putting in a double shift here. Aaron Ward, Devin Shea, John Tiger. I don't know if he can stay awake, but he's doing his best. And we want to thank everybody for watching our show. We're up to 1549 likes on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook, so thank you very much. You can watch us on YouTube, and we've been getting a lot of great feedback here in all the communities. And we're going to do our first segment, What's on Our Mind. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine, Smokin' Jim Frazier, and Chip the Prophet Hayner. I usually start with Smokin' Jim, but since we're at Sips, I'm going to start with Chip the Prophet Hayner. I'm serving up the volleyball to you tonight.
All right, thank you very much, Alan. And, you know, as Pittsburgh sports fans, you know, we always seem to be hypercritical of all of our teams. You know, the Steelers have been the latest target of most of our venom for the way they started the season. They seem to be turning things around. So after a win, you don't hear much criticism. And, you know, being a loyal Pirate fan and driving that bandwagon for a lot of years while the Pirates were laughing stocks, put up with a lot of abuse. I'm just wondering why the Pittsburgh Penguins seem to get a pass on this. You know, right now you look at the Pittsburgh Penguins and they say, everybody says that it's got the most talented team in hockey. We've got some of the highest paid players in the world. And they are severely underperforming. And I want to tell you right now, if the playoffs were to start today, the Penguins would be a first-round exit. They would lose the first-round series in less than five games. You've got players like Evgeny Malkin, who got a huge raise, who has not scored a goal in 13 games. Sidney Crosby, making $8.7 million a year, has not scored a goal in 10 games. One of the problems the Penguins seem to be having lately is they can't seem to score goals on five-on-five situations, which is the majority of when the game is played. In their last five games, four of those five games, the Penguins have only scored one goal. I don't know if it's the players or if it's the coaching. Maybe it's the system that the coach has the players in isn't suiting their talents. But something needs to change in the way they're doing things. Now, today they announced that they're going to make some line changes. They're breaking up the number one line, which some people say is the best line in hockey. I think some more drastic changes should be made, and I think it's about time that somebody lit a fire under their butt. And the fans, I think it's about time they should take them to task. That's what's on my mind.
And, Chip, I appreciate that. Late-breaking news, they still have a power outage. And it's 10 minutes into the game in the first period. So that's a nice thing being at Sip Sports Bar. I'm going to skip the segment on Sip Sports Bar and go right to Smokin' Jim. What's on your mind?
Hey, thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. I'll be real quick. This Saturday, all four WPIL football games, I'll be sitting in the press box at Heinz Field with my good friend Lynn Swan and his wife, Charina Schaefer.
Is Gatorade playing?
Yeah, the Kamikaze Kid. But I tell you what, Lynn Swan is a great guy. I'm so proud of him for being in the Hall of Fame. A great, great friend. Both of his sons are playing for Central Catholic this year. And I always thought that maybe Lynn Swan suffered a little bit from a concussion when he thought he could be governor. And that's what's on my mind.
Thanks, Smokin' Jim. I don't know what to say. I'll start with some fundraising that I do. We got the Pittsburgh-Cleveland tailgating with Howard Hanna at Peter's Place in Bridgeville. They've sold out the $20 blocks. They got $10 blocks now, Smoke and Jim. Went 150 at halftime, 350 at the end of the game. Check it out. I'll be there. My friend Bill Russo's out there going through the neighborhoods. They're rounding up everybody. $800,000 they're going to get for that. It's a great fundraiser. Then our friends at Pittsburgh Kettlebell and Performance donate the food. Check out on Facebook how to get a hold of them. You can see it right now as I cover up my face. Thanks, John the Tiger.
You never look so good.
Thanks, Mario. Mona V. Well, now I want to talk a little Steelers since they've had the easiest schedule. Everybody's jumping on the bandwagon. Me too. I was with Smoke and Jim. They win one game. I wanted to see a second win. They gave me another W. Now they go to Cleveland. They'll get another one there. They have the potential to run the table. And then the divisions come back to them. Cincinnati has to play us again. We're going to beat them. They got a couple hard games out there to play. They could lose those games. We could, in theory, in my theory and a couple others, this is why, without the Kool-Aid, they could win the division. Who cares about the wild card? The destiny is in their hands. And I'm not being the schizophrenic fan that said, okay, they've won a couple. They have an easy schedule. We got a line that was, I don't know how it even played. They tackled some guys. Big Ben, the front office, did the smartest thing that I've seen them do in years. They planted a rumor out there. My hat goes off to the front office of the Steelers. That was brilliant because nobody's taking credit for it because it isn't credible. They said it. Big Ben is so upset that he's playing better. He's hitting receivers that can't even catch a ball, and they're catching the ball. Look at Antonio Brown. What's he still leading the league? Unbelievable. Here he was crying in the second week, and he's producing. That's what you need. Big Ben doesn't have much time. Who cares? He's a horse. What did he run for 9 yards or whatever in that third down play, second down play? He wants to win now. Thank goodness for the front office. Keep those rumors coming. That's what's on my mind. This is Dan Wagner's manager.
Right-hand man. General reconnoiter, storyteller, et cetera, entertainer.
All right, you got 2 minutes. So if you can get it all in 2 minutes,
all right, you know what?
Tell us who you are.
All right, in that case, if I've got 2 minutes, I'm going to do something special for you in this 2 minutes. I do need your help, though. As the general reconnoiter of Pedal Power Tours.
Oh, I'm nervous.
He got a great voice. Great voice.
If you're hiring, I'm here. What I have here is...
We are. You'll get the same pay as us, only I'll multiply it by 10.
Perfect. So what's 0 times 10 again?
I don't know. I went to KO.
Oh, wait. What class?
74.
No class. Class of 2006.
Oh, an alumni.
I know.
Oh, man, I could tell. He couldn't multiply.
I know.
Is this a straitjacket?
Yes, this is. This is a regulation U.S. straitjacket. And what I want you to do, since I have 2 minutes to talk about this... Please check this out, and if you would mind, when don't you feel like putting me in this thing?
Putting you?
Oh, yeah, Chip!
We're mic'd up. We're mic'd up, buddy.
That's why I say put me in it.
Okay, Devin.
All right.
You've had all the experience in this, Devin.
All right. Now what this is, I'm wearing them.
This will be more than 2 minutes, but it's worth it.
I can get fast.
You're already a minute in.
All right, perfect. Now what this is a regulation U.S. straitjacket. There are no... Absolutely nothing wrong with this. Now, what I want you to do...
Face the camera.
Perfect. Well, got to look at the back, too.
We don't care about the back.
All right. What I want you to do, start at the very top. Buckle in as tight as you can. Come on. That's as close as you got. Come
he
on.
He just dislocated his shoulder already.
Not yet. However, that's later.
Can I take that to Steel Valley High School? That straight jacket.
See, I feel like making a joke about Brashear here right now, but I feel like it's bad taste.
It is.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, considering recent events.
But yes, but hey, since I'm the one who's the captive at the moment, might as well have a captive audience. But as the general manager of Pedal Power Tours, we go out every week.
Okay.
We go out every day. Okay. We're going to be running. Rain, sleet, snow, whatever. All right, perfect. Now what I want you to do, I'm going to take this arm. I'm going to cross this arm right about here.
Mm.
I want you to do this right here. Although, nope, better one for you. I apologize for any jokes I made. I'm going to swing this through to you.
Grab it, Devin!
All right, be gentle with me. All right,
This is a family show, and it was.
Oh, this is a family show.
Yeah.
Thank you for telling me before I get into this. Tomorrow.
You're the one that just walked up here. He just come in off the street, folks.
I'm going to put this back around here. I'm going to put this right here. That's what I want you to do.
You're at 2 minutes and 30 seconds. How'd we stay under 2 minutes?
All right. So we want me to get it this fast? All right. Wow. Now, of course, this is something that I do, you know, for the weekends for fun. This is also actually part of the ghost tour that runs.
Say but that I'm, again, the
this
ghost.
This is actually part of the ghost tour that runs with Battle Power Tours.
Okay.
You can't get out of that. You can't get
Houdini
out of that.
Hasn't met his match yet.
Get out of that.
Strangely enough, Houdini actually performed this
I know.
In Pittsburgh 1907.
I've read about it.
Wasn't he in water?
Yes, he was.
Unbuckle that, Devin. Unbuckle that. You can't get out of that.
All right. Now, of course, I do follow his escape route exactly, including the whole one, two, three. Dislocating the shoulder.
No! Oh my goodness!
Now, of course, you just get the break.
This is a BP TV first. Oh, and he's not out yet. He might drown.
And of course, the part my dentist absolutely hates.
He just chipped the tooth.
Oh man, you see that shoulder pop out?
Man. The sound effects are better.
Now, of course, if we're going to get from the really family-friendly portion of this thing.
Woo!
There we go, right there.
The sound effects are what made it.
Now, of course, in regards to this...
Don't mess up your beard.
Christmas is coming.
Please.
So we all have this ugly sweater that their grandmother gets. The exact same way getting out of this.
Don't mess up the beard.
Right. Andrew, I would have bet against you. Watch you don't get hit that beer in that case.
Oh, this is amazing.
Brandy, take that photo.
Houdini!
Thank you. Now, bear in mind, you get a full 2 hours of that entertainment whenever you book on the
tour. I don't get very many votes around here. If he doesn't become number 8 right now, then there's a problem. Right now.
Hold it.
If you shave the beard right now. Right now.
You were right. You did it very fast.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
It. Now, what do you want to promote here?
All right. Well, I definitely want to promote the Pittsburgh Pedal Power Tours because that is my bread and butter, let's be honest.
Okay.
I've also got shows coming up. I'm actually headlining for a benefit at the Children's Museum. Whole weekend after Thanksgiving, shows at 1 and 3. It's coming out. It's a great cause.
Okay.
And like I said, book us up, and should the Steelers
How
be
do they get a hold of you?
Just go right to the Children's Museum website.
Oh, okay. Well, we have to know.
Of course. That is childrensmuseum.org or pittsburghpedalpowertours.com.
Andrew, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having
that
me.
That was awesome.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Pleasure.
Tom, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Al. Fellas, good to see you again.
Great to see you again, Tom.
I hope Mr. Puniverse Bob Atlas was supposed to be here today. He had an emergency with his family and was unable to make it. So anybody tuning in hoping to see Mr. Puniverse maybe somewhere down the line, we'll be able to have Mr. Puniverse. And,
we're
going to
work
wishes.
On rescheduling him.
Yeah.
I hope everybody's fine. I hope
best
he's
wishes
fine.
To his family. Oh, and don't adjust your sets. I am not Toronto Mayor Rob Ford.
I got to tell you, that guy has achieved rock star status.
Wow. Wow. Great point.
Yeah.
I wanted to let everybody know, thanks in part to Pittsburgh Sportsline. We had a great event on Saturday night in Sharpsburg, Volunteer Fire Department, fundraiser, and the Mario Ferraro Senior Memorial Tournament. Right.
I saw a lot of the photos.
A lot of photos, and we had a record-breaking crowd, a lot of excitement and enthusiasm. It was a great night, and here tonight to talk about the fundraiser coming up this Saturday night up in Bloomfield. The guy earlier today talking about Bloomfield, I think he talked about a Bloomfield sandwich shop as well. Have a sandwich before you go to St. Maria Gorith School, 321 Edmund Street in Bloomfield. We have a fundraiser, KSWA, Keystone State Wrestling Alliance, Pittsburgh's only pro wrestling organization, fundraiser for the Catholic school up in that neighborhood.
Great.
We Sounds return great. After, used to be Immaculate Conception. We have had fundraisers there in the past. This is our first time there back in, I think, 2 years.
Oh, good.
But that is this Saturday, and, of course, we're leading up to
What
to
time
Fan
on
Fest.
Saturday?
7 p.m.
7 p.m.
All Never tickets are $10.
Who won the Memorial Tournament Saturday night?
Chris Cash. from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Okay, he defeated Sean Blanchard, the enforcer, despite the fact that the enforcer, Sean Blanchard, had a bye after his first round. The two guys,
no way,
Kaida and the Blood Beast, wrestled to a no disqualification.
We have to
double count out.
No way.
So Sean Blanchard had a bye. He was in the finals, but he lost to Chris Cash, who defeated the King of Millville, Del Douglas, as well as the Jester to get into the finals of the tournament.
What exciting. When's your article coming out on that? I can't wait.
It was already published.
I missed it.
It's already...
I've been trying to promote your stuff out there.
I know you do. You're great. Also, last week I had a story published in The Patch regarding the Pittsburgh Bullets.
I promoted that. I tweeted it.
Yes, you did.
I'm trying to boost up all your shares and likes, because I don't know why they don't check you out on, what is it, the Brookline, Dormont,
Dormont Patch. Brookline Patch.
You got to go there. Just Google it, bang it.
What you can do is go.
No.
There is a South Hills one.
We don't have a Bethel.
All you have to do is go to Google and hit Patch, and then the page will give you a... zip code that you can put in. They'll tell you what zip code.
His articles are even better than he speaks.
Well, thank you very much.
I enjoy reading every one of them, even your private ones that you put out. I can't keep track of what's Patch, what's not.
Yeah. I was explaining the Mario Tempest. I just enjoy writing. I love the craft of writing. Sharing literature with Smoking Jim.
Hold it, wait.
Wait. Why don't you sharing present literature. That officially to them so we can start the count on November 18th at 9:04 p.m. Give them the book right now, please.
I certainly will. I was in a bookstore, The Measure of a Man, a spiritual autobiography by the great Sidney Poitier. It spoke to me, and it said, Smoking Jim needs this book.
I am so honored. I'm going to start reading it tonight.
That's as far as he's going to get.
Oh, no.
The good news is it's in English, Smoking Jim. I checked already. It's in English.
Oh, you guys are teasing my friend here. I gave him a book. Cut this.
I'm sorry, bro.
Cut this. Dave Cable, cut this. It's contagious. I mean, a guy dislocated his shoulder, and they're still laughing about that. He graduated KO. They're still laughing about that. We're not going to have 5 minutes in. God. We edit that. Take the audio out. Just show him. Show him. And I want to get a little
you
serious.
You set him up with that one, Travis. You set him up with that one.
That was too easy for me. I'm going to give you a little challenge, Smoking Jim. I gave him a book that I read years ago on black baseball players. And he actually read 17 pages. Because how do I know? Because one of them was about one of the greatest second basemen shutting the light out and being in the bed before the light went out. And he uses that. So it was within 17 pages. So he has read 17. Well, maybe. All right, Tom, it's your time.
You are a Cal U student. You were a Cal U student. So
Graduate.
1990, what year did you graduate?
I never tell my age.
I know you're after me, so that's a good thing. But, yeah, the KSWA this weekend, and then our road to Fan Fest December 7th. I understand the MMA
Would
fighter has a day.
Would you come back next week so you can talk about the December 7th?
Absolutely.
One? Okay, because I just wanted to check your schedule.
Anytime. Give us a fill-in on events of this weekend as well.
He just was.
Yeah.
No, this coming up weekend. Don't you have another event?
That was last weekend.
He's got so many going on.
Yeah, he's got one last weekend. He's got one this weekend.
That's right.
He just was.
And then December 7th.
That's
we
at
have
7
fan,
o'clock.
Fan Fest.
This Saturday night.
Oh.
Yeah. So next Monday, he's going to tell us about this weekend event.
Get back to bed. What are you doing next?
No, the following. All right.
Well, I know it's a little above your pay grade, Al.
But again, this Saturday night, the road to Fan Fest continues at St. Maria Gorith School, 321 Edmund Street in the Bloomfield neighborhood within the city of Pittsburgh. Hope
like
to see everybody there.
But I appreciate repetitiveness.
That's right.
And who's on the card?
We have Lord Zoltan and Justin Sane, Party Gras. They take on the Mercenaries. Nasty Nick Crane and Sniper. Nasty Nick Crane is Canada's national treasure.
No way.
Yeah, and Sniper, they are mercenaries. All year long, they've been trying to get rid of Party Gras and their
What's this Party
efforts.
Gras? You Party piqued Gras, my interest there.
Lord Zoltan, the greatest professional wrestler to ever come out of Western Pennsylvania. He is the one of the only active guys that ever wrestled with Andre the Giant.
No way.
Wow.
He was in a tag team match and the other guy lost, but the other guy got pinned, but he's fond of telling that story. And his longtime tag team partner is Justin Sane, a longtime veteran of the KSW.
You say Justin Sane?
Justin Sane.
How do you spell it?
J-U-S-T-I-N-S-A-N-E.
I like hearing him say
Justin Sane. We have the King of Millville, Del Douglas, on the card. He will wrestle El Skeletorios, who makes his triumphant return to the KSWA. He was here for a...
Where's he from?
Mexico. 17-time former Mexican
who
champion.
Who can? American.
Speaking of American and baseball broadcasters, let me announce that FanFest December 7th, I think this is the fourth year in a row, the one, the only, Lanny Fritteri returns to the KSWA as a special guest.
You are a great name dropper.
As a special guest ring announcer. And a few years ago, I was inducted into the Western Pennsylvania Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame, and I got to say that one of my idols was Lanny Fritteri, and I look over, and he's going like this. I could have died right then and there.
Well, I'm glad you did. I'm glad we got to meet you. What else
Still
do you
a great
have?
Guy.
What else do you have to throw out there right now?
Nothing right now.
Special guest for FanFest?
We have Luscious Johnny Valiant and the one-legged wonder Zach Gowan, the world's only one-legged professional wrestler. He used to be on WWE, used to be on TNA, and he is... He is a
butt-kicking contest.
A butt-kicking contest.
That's close to that.
He is a phenomenal athlete, and if you get a chance, all tickets are only $5. That's our FanFest show December 7th. We ask all of our fans to bring toys to needy kids in Allegheny County, and the crazies have responded like you would not believe, thousands upon thousands of toys over the last 5 years.
Do you have women wrestlers?
We don't have women wrestlers. Believe it or not, there aren't that many in Western Pennsylvania.
Wow.
So it's something that, at least locally, the time is not ripe right now. So a couple of years ago, there was a bunch of young ladies, but, you know, life gets in the way sometimes.
Yeah.
And they get married, have kids. Yeah. Their lives, you know, they go out, they leave their 20s and have their lives. Some great female wrestlers. One of the greatest female wrestlers ever to come out of Western Pennsylvania. Her name's escaping me right now.
That's okay.
It's embarrassing.
We'll bring it back.
It's from Western Pennsylvania.
We'll bring it back another time to do it. Next week, you can come back.
Fantastic.
And visit us. We'll talk
Thank
some
you,
more.
Guys.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you very much, guys.
KLU doing That's big right. things.
It's a pleasure to see you again.
Sit back down.
And my son's a graduate of Keystone Oaks 2012.
Yay.
So there we go.
There you go.
So that means you're the only one in the family in the Hall of Fame.
All right, thanks, guys.
I know earlier I said I was from New Jersey. My family lives in Ambridge, Pennsylvania.
Who are you?
Well, sorry. Let's start again. Gabrielle Baker. Hi. In Ambridge, as of, I want to say, last week, maybe a week and a half ago, there was a fire at the JFK apartment complex on First Street. And right now they're doing a fundraiser at the Shop and Save and at the Bocelli's on Merchant Street. The Shop and Save is in Baden. They're looking for women's clothing. I believe it's jeans sizes from 14 to 20, kids' clothes 24 months, boys' clothes 8 to 10, and you know, just
they need clothes.
Absolutely, toys, and you know, the holidays are coming up, and
Daniel,
you know, these,
how many families were affected by this?
Actually, there is 20 to 30 people without homes right now.
That's terrible.
Absolutely, and there was one older woman who actually was found in the second and third stairway, found dead. Yes, so. There's a lot of families that are hurting right now. So, you know, my family's right there. You know, I live actually in the building right next to them. So,
well,
you know,
thanks for coming out and trying to promote that.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And tell them again where it's at. So,
it's in Ambridge, Pennsylvania. Well, obviously Pennsylvania.
Right. That's okay.
The building,
you're still nervous from the show
right,
we had
right,
before.
Right. The building is on First Street, but they're taking donations at the Bocelli's on Merchant Street in Ambridge and the Shop and Save in Baden.
Okay.
So you can go to the customer service desk in Shop and Save, and you can either donate money or donate the clothes and things like that.
Sure, that's great.
For these families, absolutely. Thank you.
And if you're in that area, make sure you do stop by, and anybody else,
absolutely.
You know where to go.
Absolutely.
Thanks, Gabby.
Thank you.
Appreciate all right, we have another fundraiser. This is to help people on Thanksgiving. The Bloomfield Sandwich Shop at 4613 Liberty Avenue, 412-304-2256. They have free Thanksgiving dinners to those in need. Come in between 10 or 2, or come help deliver the meals. They need people to deliver in the areas. There's food, money, donations to ROS at the Bloomfield Sandwich Shop, or contact Erin Ward if you want to deliver. She's in charge of that. Again, that's the Bloomfield Sandwich Shop. Free Thanksgiving dinners to those in need. This is a great cause. They've been, I don't know how many, but I heard 100 maybe or more.
250 is what they did last year.
250 dinners to people. That is just awesome. Congratulations to the Bloomfield Sandwich Shop, 4613 Liberty Avenue, 412-304-2256. Thank you. Zach Brenner, he's going to make a grand entrance and debut again. He's coming back on our Tuesday night show. Hey, Zach, if you want to walk up, we'll just seat you right here.
Sorry we don't have a drum roll for you, man.
All right, Lil Z.
Wow, he's got the T-shirt on. You don't have all your gear on.
Hey, we have wardrobe change.
Welcome back, Zach Brenner. What's on your mind?
Well, I'll tell you what's on my mind. Gateway's on my mind. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Can you cut this? We did a show yesterday, Monday night at Sip Sports Bar. He brought the same line.
I'm sorry.
Who's writing your material? Here, read this one. Read what's on. No. Read what's on here.
It's a blank page.
Bingo.
I was going to read the advertisement again for the Bloomfield Sandwich Shop.
We're not making fun of a good cause. 250 dinners.
I wasn't making fun of it.
Go ahead and say it then.
Okay. The Bloomfield Sandwich Shop, 4613 Liberty Avenue, 412-304-2256. Free Thanksgiving dinner to those in need. Come in between 10 and 2 or come help deliver meals. For money, donations. I don't know. I can't read that, Aaron. I'm sorry. I'm a left-hander. I can't read that.
All right. What's on your mind?
Well,
besides Gateway.
No, I was just kidding about that.
I didn't know.
I was just busting chops about that. I
are
love
you
Gateway.
Serious?
It's all good.
I didn't understand that.
I just want to know what's going on with the Pittsburgh Penguins. Like Chip had mentioned a little bit ago, they seem to get a pass when it comes to being mediocre in the season.
Look over there in a second. She got
your never
photo.
Heard it so quiet in this place. Holy smokes. That guy got to come back and put that straitjacket back on.
Hold it, he's right there. He got a dislocated left arm.
I was really worried about what he had in that suitcase for a couple seconds there.
I wasn't. See, I'm at peace. You know, whatever happens, happens.
Well, that's right. Good for you, man, but I'm not ready yet. So you
I didn't
be
say I'm ready.
Peace.
I'm going to survive. Hold it.
Yeah, I know you're going to last 6 seconds longer. No,
I'm going to survive whatever's there.
Sad to say, I knew what was in the briefcase as soon as he opened it.
Yeah, I'm going to survive that no matter what. You're in trouble, young puppy.
No, I'm not in trouble. I'm ready. You're the one that said I'm going to survive.
I'm ready for whatever happens. No problem. Go ahead.
That's that Hill District.
Yeah. You know what? I'm heating up in here.
You're a survivor.
Just like
Brenner contract.
I'm gonna need a new towel pretty soon.
Yeah, please wash that thing.
I did. It's been washed 3 times.
Use Tide.
I do.
Zach, you were mentioning about the Penguins. You know, it seems like what is going on with the Penguins is that Dan Bylsma just refuses to change his system to adjust to any kind of in-game situations. They do the same thing over and over and over again. And right now, it doesn't seem to be working. And I think they ought to, you know, be a little bit more open to change, you know?
I mean,
one of the things they seem to do, they pass the puck around, they like to look for perfect opportunities for shots instead of just throwing it at
They've
the net
been
and getting
for
in
years,
there and
though,
banging.
Too,
this has, been a, this has been a Penguin too. Tradition.
Yeah, I know.
Fancy passes are better than shots.
Now, looking back on it in hindsight, would you trade Malkin and have kept Jordan Staal, knowing what you know now?
Yes.
Well, you know what? I mean, I think they got rid of Staal because I really think Staal didn't want to be here because Staal didn't want to play second fiddle to Crosby or Malkin. I mean, you know, Jordan Staal wanted to be a star in his own right, and the only way for him to be able to do that was go to another team. They got what they could get from him, and actually it wasn't a bad return. You know, I just don't know what's wrong with Evgeny right now, because if you look into the playoffs from last year, in the second half of last year, it seems like he has more difficulty scoring goals when Sid Crosby's playing than he does when Sid Crosby's injured.
Are you saying it's psychological?
We need Sid to go down?
No, we don't need to do that. We don't find he needs to find a way to coexist peacefully with him, and both those guys need to start filling that net with some pucks.
I think he needs more borscht. You got to get him some borscht from his mother.
Not to jump around too.
Look what they did in 2008, 2009. We went to back-to-back cups. Both those guys were scoring like it was going out of style.
Is Ben Roethlisberger worth $20 million a year?
To be honest with you, is anybody worth $20 million a year? No. Will we get paid that? More than likely.
Peyton Manning's worth about $20 million a year.
Is this a quiz session?
No, I was just asking a question. Okay. Not allowed to ask any questions around here and talking machine?
Not normally, but that's okay.
This is Tuesday night show, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wasn't sure if you were going to make a
good
day.
Well, we didn't really have any segments or anything tonight, really.
No,
you
we're
know?
Free, well, freelancing
hey,
here.
Hey, folks, wait until you get to see
this is Free Willy here.
Last night's show. With the roast, the Comedy Central roast of Al Levine by Jimmy Smetty.
Why?
Because I don't know what you did to Mad Dog with the Mad Dog.
He's the only guy I know that can make Alan Levine.
Well, you know why? Because we've battled so many times there that now we're friends. Smoke and Jim will tell you.
Yeah.
If you would have seen some of the battles in the heat, 120 degree heat.
You'll see it on reality TV and go at it.
You know what? I went through a few of these towels. And water like you couldn't believe. Aaron Ward's right there shaking her head there.
I believe Definitely. It. I believe it.
Yeah, but getting back to you, where's the certificate at?
What, for plumbing school?
No, for whatever you're doing. Anybody can lie to me, but to do it this long is just outrageous. At least he wrote a book every week.
I'm writing a book too then.
You've been giving me the certificate, and it's the same thing here. Look, that's the certificate. Now, just tell me the story. Who's this guy that has you under his thumb that you have to go somewhere that you don't want to go to do it? Don't mention his name. I'm calling him up.
For plumbing school.
Again, yeah. Yeah, here's Zach's certificate.
Well, here's my certificate. You have to get, over 4 years, you got to get 575 school hours. So I got an A+ and 575 school hours.
Let now, me sign. How many hours?
575.
He did plumbing at my house.
But I need 8,000 work hours, so if
okay,
you could sign that
wait.
For 8,000.
I'm still writing.
Is that that new math?
Work.
Is that that KO math?
Yeah. 1,001 hours for me.
Now, the only problem with that is we got to find Bill Boyce because we need a master of something. So that's what the problem
oh,
I have right now.
You're the new master.
In order to be a master has to sign off on you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You need a master plumber.
Correct.
So you just grasshopper
a master photographer.
You just grasshopper.
Correct.
Ah,
correct. So that's what we're working on.
White collar okay. brawlers commercials on.
There it is.
Football.
There's our show, Esquire Network.
They go Al Levine and Taco Machine.
You'll see me right now. Watch.
National TV.
It's true. Watch. You may see me again.
I am psyched.
Ah, that was a short version. White Collar. You got to see the commercial.
That's great.
Wow.
That's great.
Unlike that certificate, that was real.
A KO guy makes it big.
Hold it. Hold it.
Dreams do come true.
Hold it. Has anybody ever watched Monday Night Football? And anybody here?
It's on right now.
Do you remember a guy, his last name was Miller? His first name was Dennis?
It was terrible.
Hold
it.
KO.
Hold it.
You didn't know Dennis Miller was from KO.
KO.
All right.
KO. He beat me.
He may be the only guy that's smarter than you. Dennis Miller.
I think Dennis Miller claims Mount Lebanon.
Hey. Castle Shannon.
Sorry, folks. We try to keep it together around here, but
my man, you made a national TV.
Every Tuesday night.
It's because of you.
Every big hand for my man, LB, the Talking Machine.
Is this? You beat me up so bad, now you're trying to boost me up.
Oh, man,
I don't need it.
I'm pumped up to see that, brother.
I don't need it. I'm already pumped up. What do you mean? You were there. This guy's going to be on ESPN announcing fights after they hear his ringside. He's talking about guys that never fought before. You would have thought it was Sugar Ray Leonard fighting Sugar Ray Robinson.
Thank you, sir.
The guys that were in the ring. He made it the fantasy like it was reality. And the shape that they were in, some of them were in decent shape. But these guys coming off the street, they had about 4 weeks of boxing training. He made them sound like, well, not Money Mayweather, but close to it.
He has a way of doing that with women, too.
Woo!
I'm sorry, we're just winding down here, folks.
Oh, how much time do we have? I think we got a lot of time.
Hey, we got more to talk about then. Let's talk.
Yeah, we got 20 minutes. What about LeBron's kid shooting basketball better than he did at that age?
What about LeBron getting ready to field an MLS soccer team in Miami?
Really?
With Beckham, Mr. England.
Wow.
Yep.
Has he got an underwear deal again?
I'm not sure.
With LeBron?
I'm not sure.
MJ had those underwear deals.
I don't talk about men in underwear. No homo.
Well, why is it on national TV?
It's for Miss Hayner and company to watch. Oh. Why do women watch football? They're not watching it for the great play.
Zach, I'm glad you're back on the show. Oh. We missed this Skype conversation.
You might get her on the air.
Unbelievable.
What, Steph? You don't like David Beckham and
Gutchies?
You don't like David Beckham and Gutchies? I'll come into
the
stands right now.
She's not on the
show. I'll come out right now with the
microphone. I'm hearing Gutchies 2 weeks in a row. A brother never heard that before.
Next, we'll be telling you about babushkas.
Well, let's talk about Heinz Field this weekend. Oh, wait.
It was in good condition.
This is just a comedy show. What happened to the sports line here? I lost it. Where's my cards at? Oh, Pirates segment. Vote for the Pirates with the Gibbies.
Hey,
got
a pirate,
for the 2013 Gibbies.
Hey, man.
To everybody at home, what are the Gibbies?
National League MVP.
The Gibby Award.
National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. Look at that. He brought home the trophy this year.
Yeah, congratulations.
Yes, absolutely.
So we don't have, in baseball, there's just not one MVP of the whole league. We got to divide.
One for the National League, one for the American League.
So that's how Clint Hurdle got to be the NL Manager of the Year.
Exactly. Yeah, and then, you know, then they separate things because, you know, in the American Leagues, they have the designated hitter. And in the National League, we play real baseball.
Okay, well, speaking of real sports, Jimmy Johnson just won his sixth NASCAR title in the last 10 years.
That leads me to ask a question. Is NASCAR a sport?
Let me ask you this. Ask Smoking Jim Frazier how hard it was to get him to California University and tell me driving isn't a sport. Tell me driving isn't a sport.
Yeah. I want to announce on the show that my biggest original fan, my sister Hope, will be here next week on the 25th.
Hey, great.
And she says hi to Smoking Jim Chick. She met you, I think, once. I don't know if she met you, Z, but she's watched the show. I just posted up a show.
Hey, the power drop just ended.
Her husband, Gary, my brother-in-law and her used to travel with NASCAR, and it is a sport, according to them. So my sister Hope will be here. She won't be on air. She's too shy, unlike myself.
Maybe
she
can enlighten
me.
Air.
She can tell you about that.
Keep Hope alive.
You don't think NASCAR is a sport, Chip? You don't think stock car racing is a sport?
You know, I mean, not so much.
No?
You got to be running and jumping, right, Chip?
I think withstand the G-force, that you have to be some type of athlete to handle it because our astronauts.
Hand-eye coordination.
They went up into space.
and they trained like our great athletes do too. So I feel on that aspect the training, because to stay in a car for 3 or 4 hours, you could have blood clots, strokes. Well,
how did you guys make it back from Cal-U then?
Wait a second.
I didn't. I'm still there.
Alan, to speak to what you're saying about, you know, if they could do that for 3 hours without scratching or denting the vehicle, then maybe that would be an athletic event.
No, because I disagree on that. I just say go ahead and do what these people do, and if the average person can't do it, then they're an athlete because they've trained themselves to be able to do something that I can't do.
Like I said, anybody can drive 3 or 4 hours to Cal-U, but it takes a true athlete.
No, it was less than three.
It takes a true athlete.
Less than three.
It takes a true general studies major, Golden Quill Award winner, writing books that we've never heard of or seen. New York Times bestsellers.
Wait a second.
And I'm looking forward to the book February 1st.
Which
we don't know the title, but we know it's going to be big and it's going to sell a lot of copies.
Are you making stuff up?
No, I'm just telling general information.
Wait, that's the funny part.
General studies.
He didn't make up a thing yet.
Not a thing. Like, we know the number. Anything. We know the phone number of Brenner Contracting. We know Mario's great products. We know the guy that has the bicycle.
Hey, how we've about never, Pittsburgh Sports
Line we've never
on
seen
Facebook?
A book in person written by Jim Frazier in Sip Sports Bar. We know Jim O'Brien's written books. I think he has.
Alan?
Yeah.
2-0.
2-0. Penguins.
Look at that nice goal. That's Sutter on a redirect.
They shook him up.
That's Sutter on a redirect.
See that? All it takes is a little criticism. It shakes them out of their doldrums.
And they scored two goals.
Should have done this a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Well, it is Pittsburgh Sportsline. Nobody's talking about the Penguins.
We're talking about them.
Oh, okay.
Who forgot?
Chip said we should have did this weeks ago.
We did talk about them.
Okay.
I've talked about them each week.
We haven't been critical of them.
We
just
do that.
I'm just getting back into the groove.
You know
Jeez.
What? Now that we wrote Jeez. On the paper. Yeah, you might have a certificate.
Yeah. I need a master to sign off on 8,000 hours if anybody knows one.
Yeah, here. Master. You need a master plumber to say you work for him.
Yeah, for 8,000 hours. And I'm done.
8,000 hours.
Yeah. 8,000.
You better do some math on that one. That's going to take you a while.
What, to work 8,000 hours?
Yeah.
No, I just need somebody to sign off on it. I've been working this whole time.
Can you prove it?
Yeah. Hey, Steph, since we got you here still, does your dishwasher work?
Well,
Hey, Steph, your toilet's running.
Still. You're supposed to fix that. Oh, man. I thought you were
Thanks,
good.
Al. That was a nice setup that you just knocked up.
I didn't know. You going to go fix it?
No, I was going to try to go catch it because it's running. Get it? Steph, is your toilet running? You better go catch it.
What is that? Ba-da-boom.
Come on, Johnny Carson.
The timing's everything, buddy. You're out of practice with how we do this.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I got a building downtown I need you to do some work on, too.
I've been waiting for years.
No, he just got that. He just got that building.
Oh, really? Finally?
It's a studio. I mean, I think there's 4 studios in that building.
Oh, really?
And I think there's a few toilets that are running.
Well, you got to wonder with Smokey Jim, though, because he doesn't just have one building. He has multiple buildings. He has scattered buildings throughout the area.
Well, here's what I did find out. He bought one of the biggest privately owned buildings in Pittsburgh. I don't know what it is, but he bought it.
Thanks, Gabrielle, making a touchdown maker. She's seen it.
She co-signed. You have good credit, dear? We could work something out.
Wow. You need a new office or something, because they could get you a building too, just like that.
Oh yeah, with the urban
there's
redevelopment.
No, there's a no trade zone there. Oh, I mean free trade. Did I misspeak?
I don't know. I've been waiting for minority contracts from Jim Frazier for a long time. I don't know if it's gonna happen.
For anybody just tuning into this show, this is called the Smoking Gym Laughter Hour.
On Tuesdays.
And we went off the reservation so far. I don't know if we can bring it back, even if I can. No, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, we get serious. We got some big fights coming up on November 30th.
Why don't you tell us about that? Because we only got about 5 minutes. 15 minutes now. They keep adding time.
Oh, that's great. 15 minutes more. That's great. I know everybody can't look at all these people here. Patience is wearing thin.
Yeah, it is. 15 more minutes. What sport didn't we cover?
Pit basketball.
Look at that.
They just set a record. They beat Howard by like 100 points.
They're 3-0.
I thought Howard.
I didn't even know Howard
was started out 3-0. They're beating the teams they should beat by 25 or 30 points. I don't know how that's going to help them when they finally get into ACC play and start playing some real basketball.
What about Duke and the Tar Heels?
That's what I'm saying.
Sam Bridge when they get there.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to get
you know what? To be honest with you, I think the ACC that they moved into is going to be just as strong as the old Big East used to be. I used to think the Big East was the best basketball conference out. But the ACC's got a lot of talent in it, top to bottom.
But does Pitt have any of that talent?
We're going to find out, aren't we?
Well, they're beating nobody's by 25.
Well, I mean, so does everybody. They're no different.
Bill Stahl was lighting up Youngstown State Penguins, and all was well in the world. And then we all know what happened with
college basketball. Your first 12 games, you play meatballs.
I know.
Okay, everybody starts out the year. They should just not even play the games and start everybody out of 12-0.
Well, they play some games on like Battleship Carriers and outside. They do all kinds of fun stuff. So yeah,
they play Jones Barber College. And they, you know, they play Grambling.
Is Grambling playing?
I don't know. I think they're still on strike. Things have gone downhill for that university.
That's bad.
Another goal. The goals keep coming for the Penguins now since they've been called out.
You know what? They change the lines around. That's what it took. Chemistry.
Oh, there's a brother in hockey.
So now, now that Smoke and Jim Frazier just found out that there's a brother in hockey, he's a huge Anaheim Ducks fan now. He still won't watch a game,
you know,
though.
What? He was the only guy cheering when Dogger scored those two goals.
That's my man. My favorite player.
He thought it was Jerome Iginla.
No, he didn't. Yager's his hero.
My favorite player.
Anybody that can go to strip clubs and eat Kit Kats, Smoking Jim likes that. Not in that order.
Hey, what, Steph, what's wrong with strip clubs and Kit Kats?
Yager is what's the problem.
There's nothing wrong with
strip clubs and Kit Kats.
Next time I go to a strip club, I'm definitely having a Kit Kat. And I'm taking it out of my pocket. I'm taking it out of my pocket before.
Are you?
Yeah, and sending it off to the side.
So. No, just carrying a separate bag. Okay. You might have some trouble with that. Now that we covered strip clubs, Yager.
That's about it.
That's it.
Yep. You ever see the movie Forrest Gump?
No. I think
he finally gets to a point in that movie where after he named like 400 different kinds of shrimp and everything about Jenny, that he like has nothing left. He's like, that's it. R.I.P. to JFK.
So you're saying this show's like a box of chocolate?
Yeah. You never know what you're going to get.
You sure it isn't like stupid is or stupid does?
We got fans that say, I think we can think of another sport. Any other sports? We got boxing.
Curling.
You didn't even. He's a choreographer.
Hey, look at the size of that gentleman talking about curling.
Hey, I totally see you playing curling.
Along with tossing logs, kegs.
Yeah. All right.
All right, that happened once.
Don't, please don't wear a skirt or a kilt. No, you can't.
We got Chip with high school football this weekend.
Championship Saturday. Four games in Heinz Field.
Two Storrocks fans at this table.
Well, you know what? That's, you know, just the way the ball bounces. You can't win them all back. You know?
No, you can't.
You can. It's time for somebody else to take the championship. Hey, Clarendon had a hell of a run, man. Five championships in a row. Nothing to be sneezed at, all, Jim. You know,
hey, listen, that zip code that it concludes Clarendon and TJ, that's a whole lot of winning that took place since 2000.
And speaking of TJ, TJ was the favorite to win it in the Triple A's this year. And they got spanked on Friday night. So, you know, they're out of the picture.
All I got to say is Smoking Jim's top 30 seniors, a lot of them will still be there on Saturday.
Wow.
You yeah, but not the top five. Because
and
they were
and how we know that the top 30, none of them came from Gateway in the top 30. Yeah.
There will be no Gators in the top 30
hey,
Smoking Jim's.
That's why he covered all the bases.
Yeah, wait, somebody that we interviewed on this program a few months back,
Eric McAllister.
Eric McAllister, his team's up for the championship in the Quad A. Big game there, Central Catholic, Woodland Hills.
Smoking Jim's top 30. I'll let you hold on to that, buddy.
Oh, man, I never get any kind of literature from Smoking Jim.
He wrote that. You want to show the folks out there? That'll be in the magazine. You're giving them a preview. No, that's his article.
It's in depth. It's breathtaking.
You have a level? Can you get a level on the top of that? It looks a little bowed. You don't see any players.
Wait, out of his top.
Hold on a second.
Out of his top 30.
The top five are Gateway.
My man, you read.
Zach, read a little further.
How long did
out of the
take?
Top 30, 22 are from Gateway.
Hey, hold on a second here, folks. I got a question of legitimacy of this list now that I'm actually reading it. He got a guy on here from Elizabeth Forward.
No. I thought it was all girls.
I thought Rod Salka was the only athlete that came out of Elizabeth Forward.
Holy
smokes.
Wait
till you hear the black and gold.
Well, at least he has our friend running back Dennis Briggs from Shadyside Academy, number 6, outside of all these Gateway guys that are in the top 5.
That's his best friend's son.
He was on the show.
Three of them are going to Temple. One of them, it says, hasn't been paid off yet. Undecided.
Whoa, where'd that go?
One of them's going to West Virginia, so his career is going to end shortly, briefly. Let's see who else we got on this list here. Oh, Brett Brumboff, 17th. Come on, man. You're killing me with this list, man. There's some guys on this list that are way down.
Who's that Stow Rocks kid?
Brendan Blair. He's in.
Is Brett Brumbaugh on there?
He's an animal. Yeah, he got Brumbaugh all the way down to 17.
He's in there. Yeah.
He's going to take South Fayette to the title this year, man.
I'm going to take a little...
I would just think this would be more legitimate if the top 5 players in Smoking Jim's top 30 seniors weren't Gateway Gators.
Hold it. You guys don't understand how he does this. This is the top 30 in the area, but he owes Gateway everything.
His life.
Yeah, so he has to put
them
in the top
5. They're making his car
five.
Payment right now.
They might have been at 28 and 29.
They're paying for my building.
Yeah. Hey, that's
I
a tribute
it.
To
Which
Coach
one?
Pete Amorino.
Which one?
86 years young.
That's still it. I believe kicking. It. Yes, sir.
Which building?
I don't know. There's a bunch of them. I haven't been called into one of them yet.
Well, do you know that girl that used to come around?
Brazil. She's in the back cave?
No, she disappeared. And it's sort of like some of this other stuff.
Well, please don't call me into a building where Brazil is.
That's the building you're going into. I'm just warning you. You wanted to know. Now, we only have about 5 minutes left. Do you have anything serious you want to bring up? Smoking Jim? Any boxing, like on December 14th?
Well, I was getting to that. I was going to November 30th at the Pulse by the 4, and then we got back to talking about Smoking Jim's top 30 from Gateway.
Hold it. Will you quit obsessing?
And some
You're
of the ages.
Show. You're back on the show, okay? You're not on probation. Not even double secret. You're on the show.
Well,
you
I'm
can
just,
talk boxing.
Chief told me to get him. So I'm just listening to Chief. Yeah, Chief's orders before he left
Where's
were
my plugs?
To get him.
I don't want to hear any of this. I want to hear boxing. Do I hear boxing?
All right, so last week.
Can I hear boxing?
Last week we signed, Rod Salka signed with Golden Boy. That's Oscar De La Hoya.
That's huge.
That is huge.
You're finally getting some national recognition.
So now the fight turns to December 17th at the Alamo Bowl in Texas at the Alamo Dome.
Is that the
It'll
14th?
Be on Showtime.
14th.
14th, December 14th.
Okay.
It's a Saturday night. It'll be on Showtime. For those of you who are subscribed to Showtime.
Come to Z's house.
Come to Munn Hall. Smoking Jim can find the NASCAR driver. It's hard to drive places.
All left turns.
All lefts, and you'll be.
Except for that one-way street you got to make a right on.
Whatever you do, don't go down 16th Avenue.
And arrive in a dented vehicle.
I cannot guarantee anybody's safety on 16th Avenue in Homestead, including my own.
What is it? Potholes there. All right, boxing now.
December 14th, Rod Salkis
Who's
fighting.
His opponent?
His opponent is Canelo Alvarez, the man who just fought Mayweather's little brother. So it's going to be a war.
Is there any titles on the line here? Or?
Yeah, there's a title on the line. Rod has two of them that'll be on
the line. They're on the line.
And the WBA now. So those two will be on the line. The only real legitimate problem with that philosophy is that Floyd Mayweather is only going to fight the biggest draw that can be drawn, that he can make the most money from. And
undefeated white guy, that's a draw.
Hold it.
That's a draw.
Smoking Jim taught me this. Rocky Marciano's record.
Listen, I was thinking about this all day, too, and I love Paul Spadafore, but who Rocky Marciano fought and when he fought them, and who Paul Spadafore fought and when he fought them, it's like literally comparing an apple to an orange. Like, it's not even ripe. It's not even right. So I want to try to steer away from comparing
Spadafore
to Marciano.
But when you're running a media and the PR, that's what they're going to say. It's all about the fantasy selling the people.
You could sell me a lot of things. You're not selling me that thing.
Yeah, but you're not buying, but I know 100,000 other people buy that.
Marciano retired the undefeated champion of the world. You know, no ties, nothing. He retired undefeated. And that, you know, somebody needs to do that before they'll catch my notice.
Yeah, that's a good point.
That's like going undefeated in football.
Miami Dolphins, 72.
Yeah, now it is again. Kansas City lost.
Wow.
KC
Did you
lost.
Really think Kansas City was going to go undefeated and win the Super Bowl?
No. No, but they lost. Just like a Steeler fan. They won two in a row. They're going to win the rest of the year. I'm on that.
Yeah, but Jim said that before they won two in a row.
Yes.
Yeah, but he also said 10-6 and wavered, just like I said 11-5, and it's not happening.
Jim saw something that we didn't.
Definitely. And we got to wind the show down. I think we're running down to the last. Whoa, 1 minute. I want to thank everybody for watching this special edition outside the studio. First time ever on VP TV with Chip the Prophet Hayner, Smoking Jim Frazier, Zach the Businessman Brenner, does everything and anything, looking for a master plumber to sign off, and Al Levine the Talking Machine. Thanks, BP TV, and everybody helping, and especially for all of you watching our show. And anybody that stayed for this doubleheader, I appreciate you. Thanks again.